Everyone, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. So this is a very important video for anyone who is taking calcium or magnesium, vitamin K, and or D3. And if you're interested in gaining muscle, losing fat, improving your memory, sleeping better, having stronger bones, better circulation and blood flow, improving your hormones, reducing your stress, and simply living longer life with less illnesses and diseases, then please watch today's video. And yes, this is a really big promise, but it's all true. And this is true for both men and women, but probably even more so for women. Now, I got asked a very important question. And they said, Dr. Robbins, can you please help clarify for me how much calcium I'm supposed to take daily? I keep hearing how important calcium is. I'm presently taking 1,200 milligrams of calcium citrate in liquid form, plus magnesium, 400 milligrams, and vitamin K2 and D3. Thank you. First of all, these are all very important vitamins and minerals that you're taking, so good job there. Secondly, I can't honestly tell you how much calcium you may need since there are too many other factors and variables, which I'll discuss today. And the only way to really know the specific answer is to do a blood test and see where your current levels are, if you're deficient and or by how much. However, I'm not going to leave you empty-handed, so let me give you some important things to think about. Now, first of all, you shouldn't be taking only the calcium citrate form. You should be taking a blend of different calciums, such as the citrate, the chelate, malate, D-glucarate, which is one of my favorites, and so forth. Now, ideally, you probably need a mix and match of a couple different brands and companies to get this mix. This is what I do. You're not going to get them all in one product. And with that said, you don't need more calcium. Now, what I believe that's even more important is magnesium, something that most people are for sure deficient in and need more of, especially women. Now, I suggest taking at least the same milligram dose of the calcium and maybe even double the dose, especially for women. So if you're taking 1,200, take at least 1,200 of the magnesium or more. But don't take it all at once or else you will probably get digestive issues. So start lower and build up. And just like the calcium, take a blend. The citrate, the oxide, the glycinate, and also what I like is L-threonate, which is one of my favorites. Now take about 75% of your total magnesium around bedtime, which will help you relax, sleep better, reduce stress hormones, and so forth. And take the other 25% of your total dose around noon, 12 o'clock. These seem to be the ideal times for best absorption and utilization. And you can also take the calcium with you as well at the same time. You know, this way you can remember taking both together. You don't have to mix and match all day long. Next is by far one of my favorite vitamins, which is D3, one that most people are also deficient in. So here's something interesting. I had been taking 10,000 units daily of vitamin D3 for a few years. And yes, that high of a dose. Most people take 2,000, maybe 5,000. Now I did a blood test and my levels were about 61 nanograms per milliliter. And the range on a blood test is between 30 to 100. Now most people and doctors will say, great, you know, that's right in the middle. You're doing great. You're doing good. However, that is not optimal. As you know me, mine, I like optimal dosages, not just normal. Now, nowadays, I'm taking 20,000 units daily, Monday through Friday with the weekends off, which works out to about 15,000 units daily. Now, I do this because I like to cycle this off, even if it's just 2 days weekly. And you don't have to do this. It's just me, because I'm taking such a higher dose of this fat soluble vitamin. And yes, it's a crazy high dose. But at this dose, my blood test level is now 93 nanograms per milliliter. I believe that the very upper limit range of this normal, the 300 to 100, is optimal. Mine is 93, and I like it there. Again, it's always best and ideal to do a blood test to remove all the guesswork as far as how much you may need or require. Now, the unfortunate truth is that I should be getting a lot more sunlight to help absorb the D3 better and help my own body produce more of the vitamin D3 based on also the amount of cholesterol I'm eating daily. But honestly, I just don't make the time to go out in the sun and have the UV rays hit my body daily for 20 to 30 minutes. I should, but I don't. So instead, I supplement with the extra D3. And again, it's a high dose. It's not the best move, right? You shouldn't always take supplements, But this is what I have to do for now because I'm just not getting enough sunlight. I'm making time for it. I've got a busy schedule. Now, I'll share something interesting with you about the magnesium and the D3 as it pertains to calcium, and I'll tell you that in about a minute. However, let's quickly talk about vitamin K. Now, this is also an extremely important vitamin, and I believe that in a few years, it will regularly be tested like D3 is these days. That's how important vitamin K is. Needless to say, if you're not taking this other important fat-soluble vitamin, vitamin K, please do so now. And this one, you want a mixture of K1, K2, and a very important one, which is a K2, which is MK7. So here's the cool part. When you take more magnesium and D3, you actually absorb more of the calcium. That's why you don't need a higher dose. And the vitamin K, especially the K27, all right, helps take the calcium out of the blood and puts it into the bones where it should be. This improves your blood flow. It helps reduce plaque and calcium buildup in your arteries and veins, which again reduces your risk for having a heart attack or stroke. Now, this combo also helps build stronger bones, right? Improves your hormones and helps with thousands of other extremely important functions and disease avoidances in the body. So in summary, there you have it. Calcium is important. You should take a blend of it. However, taking magnesium blend, all right, combined with the D3 and the K helps you absorb and utilize more calcium. The great side benefit to all this is better circulation throughout your entire body, which is great. And there are actually a few other vitamins and ingredients that you can take if you're interested in improving your blood flow from head to toe, muscles and veins and arteries and your brain. And the list of these important ingredients is below in the description area with actually a formula that I take personally myself, as do both of my parents. If you aren't already, make sure you subscribe to this channel and then click the bell icon.